Very wonderful and happy day to you. So today we have this topic that why is it that we form negative opinion about people? We keep meeting so many different types of people. Some people are good to us. Some people are bad to us. Some people ignore us. And we start forming opinions. Some behavioral scientists have even gone to the extent of saying that we start forming opinion about people within 10 seconds. You just look at another human being. The person may not even be paying attention to you or talking to you, but just by looking at him, his demeanor, his expression, maybe even his way of dressing, the way he is walking or sitting, and within 10 seconds, we start forming an opinion. And they say that that first opinion that we form gets either changed or confirmed within 4 to 5 minutes. That's amazing, no? I get quite a few people, our students, and I tell them this, they generally say, no, I'm not that type of person. I don't form opinion about people so easily. Unless I really know the person, I don't form an opinion. That's what we think, but it's not true. I may not express that opinion. I may not say what I am thinking or feeling about that person, but in my mind, I have started forming an opinion. Now, the interesting thing is, if my opinion is very neutral, in the sense that the person doesn't seem to be very interesting for me, I don't want to, you know, give my attention to this person or waste my time on him, rather, seems to be somebody very insignificant according to me, then I ignore, I forget. And after some days, if somebody asks me, that day you had met such and such a person, I say, no, I don't remember much. So that is one category of people. The second category is, if you like something about that person. And the third category is, if you dislike something about that person. The interesting thing is, I'm not saying you specifically do it, but in general, many of us do it. If I form a positive opinion, I just make it very brief, very simple, and say, oh, he's a nice person. She's a good person. Full stop. But if I form a negative opinion, I don't stop. Normally, it should be the other way around, no? When I find somebody who has been good to me or seems to be having good characteristics, I should be taking more interest in that person. I should be analyzing him deeper. I should be commenting more about him. And if I don't like a person or I form a negative opinion, I should let him go anyway. He's not a good guy or he's not doing anything good to me. So why should I waste my time on him? But human behavior is such that we focus only on this third category. The slightest negative opinion, and we start spending time on analyzing that person. This has a background behind it. When we are very small, our elders, our parents, whoever they are, they try to protect us. So you may or may not remember, but you were told 100 times when you were very small, don't talk to strangers. Don't go out of the way. Don't go to that other area. Don't go on a strange road. Don't go alone without anybody. There are all sorts of people around. We are even told some lies about people. Don't go past that slum area, you know. Those people are not very nice. You don't know anything about those people in the slum. But with all good intention, you want to protect the child. So you don't want to take a chance that if the child goes there and if somebody misbehaves with him or does something to him, it can be a problem. The same way as we say, don't cross the road without the help of an adult. The vehicles are coming at speed. There are so many rash drivers. Again, the intention is very good. I want to protect the child. But the sad thing is, as the child grows up, we do not undo that protection. We don't say, yes, now you are a big person. Now you can go past that slum or you can cross the road. Because generally people do drive carefully. Nobody goes. Once in a while, somebody may be, you know, driving very rashly, but most of the time it doesn't happen. So some of these things which are indoctrinated into us as small children, they remain with us. Then there's another reason. If you like somebody, just casually, you see somebody or you meet that person for a very brief while and you find something good and you tell a third person, hey, this person is so nice, so polite, so smiling. This person does some good gestures. The person is very kind to everybody. The person whom you are talking to gets bored. The person doesn't want to listen to you. But the moment you say something negative about a person, you know, so and so has got this bad habit. You know, such and such person, he looks so innocent, but he is not. Immediately the antenna goes up. And the listener starts off, tell me more. I want to know. And when that person says that, what happens? You feel important. You feel proud. Attention is being given to you. And because the listener is asking you more and more about these so-called negative qualities, at times you feel tempted to even exaggerate, to say things which you have no evidence of. And we go on and on and on. And that turns into what we refer to in very simple terms as gossip. The number of times that we indulge in idle gossip, if there was some meter, if artificial intelligence or somebody, you know, devises some sort of a meter by which, like, how now they have this thing to, you know, check out how many steps you have walked the whole day. So you put on that wristwatch and keep it. And at the end of the day, you see how many steps you have walked. And they say you have to walk 10,000 steps. And if you have not done that, at the end of the day, you walk some more to make sure that those 10,000 steps are done. So you see how technology is helping us in that. I wouldn't be surprised if technology tomorrow comes out with these things. Not that people would be interested in measuring how much gossip they do. But if artificial intelligence helps us to record the number of minutes or the number of hours of the gossip that we do, you yourself will be shocked. You will refuse to believe that, no, this can't be true. Once in a while, I may be doing that too, you know, if I want the others to be protected or I want to just, you know, take precautions or something like that. But otherwise, no, I do not indulge in gossip. And gossip need not be some, you know, group getting together and saying, come on, now let's sit and gossip and talk about some people. No, it happens so automatically. In fact, I don't know whether you've noticed, let's say four people are sitting together. They are friends or acquaintances or colleagues or neighbors, whatever they are. Four of them are sitting in, having a nice casual talk. One of them excuses herself and says, no, I have to go. Sorry to leave you people. I'm going. You will be amazed at how once that fourth person leaves, the topic of discussion turns from whatever was being taught to person number four. The tendency is so strong. Why did she go? I don't know where she goes, what she does. No, I think she's very proud. She doesn't want to spend time with us. I've seen her doing this earlier also. She's this type of a person only. For a simple thing like, instead of all four dispersing at the same time, one excuses herself early and becomes the topic of negative discussion. Now, this is also connected to suspicion of the unknown that again starts with children. Have you noticed how many children are scared of the dark? Supposing you live in a two-storied house, you're all sitting on the ground floor, and you have left something in a room on the first floor. You tell a little child, just go up in that room on the table. I've kept certain such things. Pick it up and come back. The child may say, no, I'm scared to go. It is dark. If you say, okay, there is a light switch downstairs also. I'll just put on that light. Now you go. And the child happily goes. What is the difference? The difference is what we call as the fear of the unknown. Now, a child may have a genuine reason of being scared that because it is dark, there may be some monster sitting over there. But this gets so ingrained in us that anything that is unknown, I told you now why we say, don't go past that slum, take the other road. Do you know who lives in the slum? Do you know what type of people they are? Do you know whether they harm you or not? You don't know anything. But because it is unknown, the other road you're talking about has middle class houses. So they are part of our society. This road has got a slum where people who are different, only different, mind you. And yet we are not open to even allowing them the privilege of me saying, I don't know, they may be good, they may be bad. I have no idea about them. This thing of wanting to be, you know, very, very, what do you say, you come out with the type of people who are there, and then I can show up by saying, I know something about people. This is one of the reasons. Okay, let me also tell you some very interesting thing that some of us indulge in. If a friend is asking me, do you know so-and-so? I think he's a good friend of yours. Now, if I want to be genuine, I can say, yes, he's got some good qualities. I like him. Or I can even say, no, I don't like him much because he has got some negative qualities. But you know what I do? I play games. I tell them, you're asking me about so-and-so. No, I better not say anything. Now, what have I said? I have only said, I better not say anything. Have I said something bad about that person? No. If somebody questions me later, I can swear and say I did not say anything bad about that person. But what have I conveyed by saying, I better not say anything about people? And this goes on and on, which increases the threat that I keep on repeating, the threat of loneliness. The more you have a habit of forming negative opinions about any people, you have started building walls. And the more walls around you, the more isolated you are, and the chances are that you are headed towards loneliness. That is one of the reasons why I took up this topic to discuss with you about these things. Just to give you a quick example on this, we made a small PPT in which we listed out some categories of people. I want you to visualize and answer to yourself truthfully whether you have negative opinion about any one of these categories, one or more rather. Have a look. What are these categories that we have listed out? Rich people. Many of us say, rich people, how do they become rich? Only by cheating others, no? Nobody can become rich by honest means. So if somebody is rich, that person must be a bad person. Then government officials, they are all corrupt. They are inefficient. They are just throwing their weight around. They never serve public and society. Is that a fact? Yes, you may have had some negative experiences with some government officials. That doesn't mean that I have a right to condemn all of them. Talkative people, people who talk a lot. I don't want to have anything to do with that person. Just goes on talking. Okay, he goes on talking. But does he talk bad? Does he say things which are not true? Does he say things which are not acceptable to you? No, not necessarily. The opposite of that, silent people. People who don't talk at all. What's the point in talking to you? He is always quiet. He never says anything. I was asking him, tell me about such and such thing or such and such. People, he's just not telling me anything. Look at him, how he is. House help, domestic servants, maid servants, drivers. Again, we tend to put them in one category. Then policemen, they are always the butt of people's criticism. They throw their weight around, they harass people, they are corrupt, they never do their duty properly. They are only catering to the big shots. I just at random picked up one category of people, Arabs. Most of us have had no interaction with Arabs. Arabs hardly come to India, and not many of us have visited Arab countries. But ask yourself, do you have a negative opinion? Do you have a negative opinion about what you are categorizing as secretive people? People who don't talk much about themselves. It may be that they're very modest. It may be they must be thinking that I don't like to brag about myself, so I don't talk. Now you label them as secretive people and you say, I don't like them. Famous people, celebrities, any celebrity, and we have enough and more negative comments to make about them. This trolling, which has become so common now. Anybody who is very well known, a celebrity, a famous person, there will be enough and more people trolling them, talking negative things about them without knowing anything about them. Same thing with people in authority. It could be politicians, bureaucrats, whatever, you know, people who have some authority or power in their hands, a top industrialist or somebody. We inevitably think ill of them. We think negatively about them. Introvert, the same way as I mentioned about silent people. People are generally introverted, who don't make new friends, who stick to their own known people. He is so proud, you know. He will only talk to A, B, and C. Why will he talk to us? Remember, he's got nothing to do with it. That's his temperament. And of course, the most common one, I think, nobody spends as much time talking about any category of people other than politicians. So this was just a sort of representative list that I gave you to help you to think. I want you to do yourself this favor of checking out of this list or any other list also. Do I have a habit of generalizing, putting down, commenting in a very uncharitable way about certain categories of people or even certain individuals? This fellow, I don't know what sort of person he is. He never smiles at me or he never talks to me. is it a crime or is it a sin not to smile at you or not to talk to you? He lives in his own world. And maybe, as I said, no, he may even be a shy person. He may be an introvert. Not that he doesn't want to be nice to you. He sticks to only his known people. But we take it so easily to be able to think negatively about such people. Along with this, I also wanted to give you a small little exercise to help you to understand the topic of today. I do this with a lot of people. Let's say doing a teacher's orientation program or anywhere, I do this, and you see the way the results comes out. Think of one person whom you don't like for whatever reason. Either you don't know enough about him and you don't like him, or he has actually done something bad to you, or you have heard from some third person that the person is bad, whatever it may be. Just visualize in your mind one person who you do not like, you're not very fond of, or you do not have a very positive opinion about him. You're entitled to that. Take a piece of paper and within 30 seconds, write down 5 good qualities about that person. 30 seconds and you have to write. If you get stuck, if you're not able to write anything, or you write 1 or 2 and then you get stuck, the issue is not with the person, the issue is with you. Because you are only looking at the negative side of things. The worst of people also have some good qualities. Don't forget that. There is nobody on earth who has only negative qualities. So, when you think of a person whom you don't like, for whatever may be the reason, justified reason, but when you cannot think of 5 good qualities about that person, as I said, there is something wrong with you. You have become negative. You have become critical. You have become judgmental. And this happens across the board. In fact, what we did was that we shot a little bit of a small video of a person. These two ladies are talking. They live in the same building complex. And some third person has moved into that building complex. The first one seems to have already formed a negative opinion and is gossiping to the second one, saying, I don't like this person. See what happens. Hear it out.
Hey, Smita, come sit here. I want to tell you something. You know what happened? Oh, have you seen that 103 lady, tall lady? Hi Kanaka. Oh, are you speaking about Kanchan 103, right? Very weird and fishy. Something is wrong. You know, they just came 1 week before. She's giggling, laughing all the time whenever she's here. And she has made so many new friends. Abba, it feels so weird. At this age also, what man? And you know her son? Very strange people. All the while, I don't know, I see late night parties, so much of music and angama. Wow, this outside has come and spoil. Feeling, wow, very weird. Oh, that Kanchan. Oh, she has such a beautiful smile. And sure, she has that handsome husband. And I heard she does a lot of work. And she has got some few awards also. And all the apartment people also help her a lot. Oh, she's totally famous here. Oh, is it? You know what, Kanaka? The other day, you were looking for your son's admission in a kindergarten, right? And you said, it's quite difficult. After you spoke to me that you asked for help, I went and asked Kanchan some help. And she, you know, without hesitation or without knowing anybody, she told that, you know, she will help. She promised. She had her cousin who is actually know a play group. And within just few minutes, she called up, and that is how your son got admission. You know that? Oh, I didn't know.
This is a representative thing about how two people talking to each other and somebody who has this negativity in her heart. Did you notice how difficult it was for her to even acknowledge, even when her friend was saying that this same lady about whom you are talking such negative things actually was the one who got admission for your son in the kindergarten? So difficult to accept, no? Because we find it so easy. If that one had said, yes, yes, I also know she's a horrible person, she would have been reinforced. She would have been happy. And she would have said, see, what I said was right. My friend also agrees. So together we can condemn that person without even knowing what good or bad qualities she has. As I said, no, we start keeping away from such people. We start forming more and more negative opinions about people. And when it becomes a habit, we tend to start pushing away people. Initially, it may look that you are pushing away one or two whom you are suspicious about, or you feel possibly they may not be good enough. But the number grows and your isolation grows. And this habit of looking for negatives, anything and everything. I've come across instances where a parent is telling the child, why are you hanging around with that Santosh? I don't think he's a good fellow. Don't play with him. And the son says, Ma, do you know anything about Santosh? Have you taken the trouble of finding out what sort of a boy he is? No, no, I don't know. See his hairstyle and see the way he dresses. How does hairstyle or dressing determine the character of a person? Even a small child is telling his adult mother, but the mother refuses to accept it. And then the son says, actually, you know what? Santosh's mother told him not to play with me because she thinks that I am not a good boy. So see how this chain reaction goes. And people get caught in this trap. And this is something which I just thought, I'm sure there are many of you who do not do anything like this, but in case we do it, definitely not 100%, maybe 50%, maybe 30%, maybe 10%. This is the time to stop, introspect, wake up, and start bringing about a change. It takes time and effort and patience. It won't happen overnight. But if you have understood the significance of not thinking negatively about people, over a period of time, you do start bringing about a change and you start feeling that the world is a better place. You're surrounded by good people. You feel comfortable. You feel belonged. Think about it. Keep a note and go ahead and start this practice if you're not doing it already. So I'll take my 1 minute break and Sonal is here to update you about what's happening.
Everyone, good afternoon. Good to see that you are enjoying Ali's talk and today's topic, especially why we form negative opinion. Many a times we don't even realize that we are forming negative opinion. I think such talks helps us being aware of it, right? Okay, let me update you with what's happening at Banjara. Last few seats have been reserved for your loved ones. So if at all you think that, you know, there is someone who wants to join Diploma in Counseling Skills, send them ASAP, as soon as possible. Very, very soon we are going to close the admissions. So grab the opportunity, send them And as I was listening to Ali about forming negative opinions and to work towards it, I was even thinking of, you know, when you do this diploma in counseling skills, it actually helps doing that. And to back up with what I'm saying, we have Vinita in the studio today, who is there in the chat box also. She will say hi to you all.
Hello. Here hi, is Vinita. Hi, everyone.
So, Vinita, you can tell how diploma in counseling skills has helped on working on, you know, getting away from forming opinions of people.
Yeah, actually, it's a total new learning, actually, I feel, you know, because what we have opinions earlier and after doing DCS, you're forced to actually unlearn few things and learn new things. You will start a new journey. Unless you do, you will not experience. That's all I can say. My journey has begun already.
Yes. So that's what diploma in counseling skills does to us. And definitely it's a journey. It's not that you do it once, twice, and you say, yes, I did it. No, it's a journey to make a habit and make your second nature into it. Yes. So please grab this opportunity. Last few seats left. Send them quickly as soon as possible. Because they are your loved ones, we are going to keep this accommodation, right? So back to Ali for the second half of the interesting answers to the questions and your sharings.
Yes, I'm back. Oh, I already see quite a few comments and questions. So Anis is going to put them up one by one and let me see what I get to learn from all this. Okay. Mess says, is it possible that our own insecurities make us form negative opinions of people? You have hit the nail on the head, Mess. Something which many of us do not wish to confess. I am feeling insecure. I am got low self-esteem. I am feeling that I am not good enough. I have skeletons in my cupboard. I am doing certain things which are not very nice. So how to deflect opinion? Keep talking about others. Keep pointing out other people's faults. You know that politicians and celebrities and all these people do it. When somebody questions them, why are you doing this wrong thing? They immediately say, isn't that other fellow also doing it? What did that fellow do so many years back? Why didn't you comment at that time? Why are you commenting about me? As though two wrongs make a right. So the same thing happens even at the individual level. That if I am scared, if I'm apprehensive, if I'm guilty, then offense is the best form of defense. Keep deflecting, keep talking about other people. Right? Surekha says, our need to put someone down will one day turn us into compulsive fault finders. We will keep on fishing for the dirt in others and cultivate the tendency of twisting the truth to support our judgment. There's a category of people, you know, who are called compulsive liars. They have no reason to lie, but they tell lies. Supposing I have got a small car. It's a very good car. It gives me very good service. I'm very happy with it. But by chance, somebody asks me, what sort of car have you got? And I say, I've got a big car, such and such model. How does it help? Does it make any difference? He was casually inquiring about different models of cars or whatever it is. And he asked me a very simple question. But I become a compulsive liar. And the same thing happens by putting other people down. So we become compulsive in putting other people down with the hope that I will be looked upon as a better person. Then I compare and say A, B, C are all people who have negative qualities. So by default, I am a better person than that. This also takes me to a very simple, thought, which I keep telling our students also, that the greatest sin is the one which I do not commit. The greatest sin is the one which I do not commit. Supposing I am a person who doesn't drink alcohol at all. The moment there is mention about somebody who may even be a casual drinker or whatever it is, I immediately start making negative and condemnable remarks. But supposing I also enjoy my drink once in a while, if there is a mention of alcohol, I'll say, no, see, everybody who drinks is not really bad. There are people who are perfectly good and very gentlemanly and this and that, but they enjoy their drink, there's nothing wrong. Why? Because somewhere that guilt is there in me that I also indulge in that. So whenever I have that high and mighty approach also, that's another time when I keep putting other people down. Hema says, DCS definitely transforms ones. Thank you, Hema. This is something which we keep hearing every now and then. And more than making us proud, it makes us humble that there is an inner transformation taking place among people who have gone through this process of looking inward, looking at their loved ones, looking outward, reaching out to total strangers, understanding them, being non-judgmental about them. So like DCS, of course, there are various ways of doing things. Having a gratitude journal, as I told you, is one more way. But there are ways and means. That's what I'm saying, that if you have identified, or even if you are apprehensive that, yes, I may be forming unnecessarily negative opinion about people, let me bring about a change. Surekha also says, people who form negative opinions about others have the need to be the center of attention. Yes, I mentioned this. Anybody else getting the laughs, getting focused on, is a threat. They have a sick need for admiration, attention, acknowledgement, appreciation. And that is what I want all of us to understand, that am I doing it even in a small way? If I become aware that I am doing it, the time to start bringing about a change is now. Vinita says, sometimes, Ali, our tone changes when we talk to house helps, drivers, waiters, etc. This is what I want you to be aware of. If you have in your own mind created this sort of generalized opinion, waiters are not very helpful, drivers are very rude and they drive, harshly or wrongly, it shows in our attitude. Even the way we talk to them, you can make out that this person has formed a negative opinion. That particular waiter or that particular driver may not have done anything to you, but you've got so embedded in this negative thinking that without realizing, you're being harsh to them. I have a very dear friend who became a police officer, and within few years, I noticed, you see, with us, he was very nice, very polite, very humble, very jovial. But I used to notice this, what you're saying now about drivers or waiters or domestic help. His entire demeanor used to change. I couldn't take it at one point because he's a close friend of mine. I told him, boss, this is not done. You may be a police officer and you may be dealing with criminals and antisocial elements. So you have to be harsh with them. You have to be strict with them. All that is fine. But you can't extend that to day-to-day life. Thankfully, as he went up the ladder, he also realized. And then he started mellowing down. And in later years, he is now, acknowledged as one of the very understanding, very empathetic police officers. So this is the change that we can bring in if we put in the effort. So Rekha is asking, do these people have a preoccupation with fantasies? It is possible. Not all of them have, but definitely that could be one of the reasons. I want to live in a fantasy world. Supposing I am not rich or powerful or a person in authority, which is my fantasy. I wanted to be a multimillionaire or a big shot or whatever it is. So what I do is, by putting other people down, I am trying to show that I am a person who is in authority. I have the ability to put other people down. So I am living in this world of fantasy. Some of us do have that habit. Yeah, this we saw just now. Aditi says, if we accept everyone is different and have different ways of doing things, I feel negative thought about anyone can be avoided for personal friends. That's exactly what I'm saying, you see. Diversity. Start accepting diversity. Why did in that list I put up something like Arabs or Negroes, Africans or Americans or whatever it may be? Because their lifestyle is different. There are very conservative Indians who think that Americans are very, you know, liberal or modern or immoral or whatever. They form these opinions. But that is not true. America is a land of whatever, you know, 40 crores of people. Everybody cannot be the same. And you have no right to form an opinion about groups of people or categories of people. Surekha says they are emotionally lazy. That's a good quote, Surekha. Emotionally lazy. Judgment is easy. Empathy and compassion are hard. That's why we keep drilling into people. Please learn the skill of empathy. Please learn to be compassionate to people who are different from you and who may even be, you know, indulging in some habits which are not good. There may be a man who's very, very rude to his wife. But if you look close, you may find that he's very nice with his children. He's a wonderful father. Now, can you overlook that just because he's bad to his wife? Everybody has pluses and minuses. Aditi says, but as we talk about police or politicians, they seldom keep their words. So it's so different. I gave you an example just now, Aditi, about a friend of mine who finally rose up to the highest position in the police force. Nobody could condemn him that he doesn't keep up his word, or he's throwing his weight around, or he's doing injustice. There are people like that. It is up to us to look. One is to look, if you feel politicians are bad, look for one good politician and you will find that. One of them happened to be my classmate, Manohar Parikar. 4 times he was chief minister of Goa, and he had also gone on to becoming the Raksha Mantri, defense minister of India. If you know anybody who knew him closely or who was even observing him, he was a class apart. And you know what? He died at a very early age, but he reinforced my faith in politicians. When I saw him and observed him, I realized that you cannot condemn all politicians. There are good people. And when you look at these good people, you feel nice, no? Yes. Sharayu, Dr. Sharayu from Dharwad says, my father always used to say, maximum time is wasted in self-appreciation and criticizing others. Very wise thoughts, Sharayu. You are very fortunate to have such a parent who has drilled these basic values into you to help you and all of us to understand that this is what is the reality is. And as Sharayu says, both give negative vibes. So it's up to us. We have a brain. We have the power of thinking. We can decide what is right and wrong. We can choose what to focus on. Then we have Surekha saying they have a lack of empathy and the instability to stand in anyone else's shoes and to identify and reflect with the feelings of others. Yes, this is what happens. People become very self-focused, self-centered. They are not open to listening to others, understanding others. And who is the loser? The person who forms these negative opinions. Don't be a loser. Mangala says, in the process of finding a fly in others' plates, we don't see a big buffalo lying in my own. We always retrospect on our own and try to be perfect ourselves first. Very well said, Mangala, you're right. Good to have Kalpana, seeing you here after a very long time. Kalpana says, I realize that I have, over the years, developed a generalized opinion that all are good people, basically. And of course, there are exceptions, sometimes. But again, that is forming opinion as well, right? Yes, where you need to protect yourself by forming an opinion. I have come to the conclusion that this person is not trustworthy in money matters. He may cheat me. So I'll take a precaution. Money is, you know, scarce and I need my money. I can't throw it around. I can't risk. So I will take a precaution of not indulging in any money matters with him. But I don't have to condemn him across the board and say he's a bad man. He may be a wonderful person with so many other good qualities. But for whatever reason, he's not trustworthy in money matters. So I will not have money transactions with him. That's how it goes. Surekha says, the hardest part is that you can't have an honest conversation with the self-opinionated person. I wonder if it is like a handicap. Yes, it is, Surekha, but it is a self-acquired handicap. That is the interesting part. Any other handicap is imposed on us. If I become physically disabled, if I do not have intellectual level of other people, if I have developmental disorders or mental illness, I'm not responsible for it. But forming opinions about people is a handicap which I have imposed on myself without realizing it. And I have to pay the price for it. So this is how it goes. Aditi says, yes, he was so different. So that's what happens, that, you know, so many things are there which keep happening around us. Small, small things. It's not rocket science to understand that we need to be more accepting of people. We need to look at the positive side of people. We need to have a neutral opinion till we know a person deeply, and we need to restrict ourselves from immediately gossiping or saying negative things. Okay, one last opinion has come in from Madhavi. Hi Ali, hope you're doing fine. Yes, long time. I have not met you all. I always come across many compulsive liars. Instead of judging them, I always feel bad. What may be the reason for them to lie? I learn from their experience, mistake, and hurting nature. But my near and dear feel, I am always finding faults in others. Learning from others' experience is negative. No, Madhavi, what you are doing is absolutely right. Keep doing it. Be answerable only to your conscience, not the opinions that others form of you. You know why you are doing this, and you know that you want to rise above all these things, and you will do it, you will succeed, and you will have a wonderful time. So with that, let me wind up for the day. And Anis has shown you the upcoming topics. The next Saturday is 10th of August. On 10th of August, we are going to be talking about unconditional love. The Saturday after that is 17th, defining your identity, who are you? And on 24th August, handling long distance relationships. So we thought that we'll let you know in advance to 3 weeks so that you know what other topics coming up. In case something looks interesting, you can mark that date in your calendar and you can make it a point to attend that, because I like people who attend because I get to learn from them. Of course, this is always available. You can see the video later also, but then I will not have the privilege of having your opinions, your comments, your questions. So that's why we are giving you these topics in advance. Next Saturday 10th, we will be meeting at 2:00 to talk about unconditional love. Right then, see you. Bye-bye.
Hey, Smita, come sit here. I want to tell you something. You know what happened? Oh, have you seen that 103 lady, tall lady? Mom. Hi, Kanaka. Oh, are you speaking about Kanchan 103, right? Very weird and fishy. Something is wrong. They just came 1 week before. She's giggling, laughing all the time whenever she's here. And she has made so many new friends. Abba, it feels so weird. At this age also, what men? And you know her son? Very strange people. All the while, I don't know, I see late night parties, so much of music and angama. Bah, this outside has come and spoil. Feeling, bah, very weird. Bah. Oh, that Kanchan. Oh, she has such a beautiful smile. And sure, she has that handsome husband. And I heard she does a lot of work, and she has got some few awards also. And all the apartment people also help her a lot. Oh, she's totally famous here. Oh, is it? You know what, Kanaka? The other day, you were looking for your son's admission in the kindergarten, right? And you said it's quite difficult. After you spoke me that you asked for help, I went and asked Kanchan some help, and she, you know, without hesitation or without knowing anybody, she told that, you know, she will help. She promised. She had her cousin who is actually know a play group, and within just few minutes she called up, and that is how your son got admission. You know that? Oh, I didn't know.